So today I wanted to talk about something that I am all too familiar with, which is buses and public transportation. So I take two buses to school every single day. So you could say that I am pretty much a professional in the field of public transportation. Call me queen of the buses and I will respond. Here are some things that drive me crazy about buses and probably drive you crazy too if you are an unlucky soul such as myself that has to ride them. Number one, when people sit beside you when there are copious amounts of seats throughout the entire bus. Like, excuse me, I'm pretty sure there are seats all around here. I shouldn't have to be pushed up against the stupid window because you want to sit beside me. I guess that's probably pretty rude, but it's so true. I mean, I get so anxious. Like, if you know that one of your bus stops is like the next one or something like that, and I have to press the button on the side or pull the handle or whatever it is that is, and there's someone beside me, I'm like, oh my God, I hope they realize that I have to get up because, you know, then I'm gonna have to ask them and I'm gonna have to like touch them and like tap them on the shoulder and oh my God. It's a hard life I live. I know, you don't have to tell me. Most of the time, the people who end up sitting beside you, there's really no problem with them. They're just regular people. But sometimes there are those people that get on the bus and you see them walk on. And you're like, please don't sit beside me. Please don't sit beside me. And then you breathe the biggest sigh of relief as you see them walking down the aisle. And you're like, that's right. Keep walking. Go push yourself on someone else. Not me. Not today. And then there's the complete opposite problem when every single seat is taken except for the one beside you. I mean, I'm a pretty confident person, but when something like that happens, I get pretty self-conscious. I'm like, what the hell? One time there was only one seat left on the bus, and that was a seat beside me, and the guy who got on chose to stand. I've never been so offended in my life. Let's call this the paradox of bus riders, because there's two sides of the coin, right? You're upset when someone sits beside you, you're like, get away from me, but when they don't sit beside you, you are the utmost offended, so we're never happy, I guess. I think that's because when somebody sits beside you, you're like, oh, you're the weirdo, like, oh God. But when nobody sits beside you, then you're the weirdo. And then sometimes you're not sitting at all and you have a whole new slew of problems, and that's from standing. I feel like sometimes my bus driver thinks that we're in like the Fast and the Furious or something because he's driving like so fast, like jerking everywhere, and I'm trying to hold this stupid pole that does nothing to help me. I'm pulling out all these like pole dancing moves to try and stay upright. And that leads me to the best bus ride I ever had. One time a guy was standing and he wasn't holding the pole, trying to be all cool and such. The bus did this big turn and he fell from one side of the bus to the other side of the bus, face first on the floor right in front of me. Both of his shoes fell off and it was the best day of my bus riding life. I still look back on it fondly. And so those are my issues with buses. If you liked it or have anything else that you want to add, be sure to comment and to like it and to do all of that fun stuff. And I will see you guys later. Please don't sit beside me. Please don't sit beside me.